New Delhi's fast becoming the pollution capital of the world, with air pollution worse than even Beijing. According to records, 3,000 people die every year due to pollution-related problems. But despite this, daily 700 diesel cars are sold in the city, which worsens the pollution load.
A city fast becoming the new pollution capital of the world adds 1,400 cars to its roads every day. Over the last decade, the number of vehicles in Delhi has jumped by a phenomenal 97%.
In 2000, diesel cars accounted for 4% of all car sales. Today, half the cars sold run on diesel. In sharp contrast, public transport system has not managed to keep pace. Despite a Supreme Court order saying 11,000 buses must ply on Delhi's roads, just a little over 6,000 are in service today.
Yet apart from customary hoardings like these, there's little evidence of a plan in action.
In my location, there is no bus. Pehle thi, but now there is no bus. We used to travel by rickshaw only. And the rickshaw wale cost around 40 rupees to the metro station. So what's the big deal? Ab 40 rupees ko it's better. Apni gaadi use karoge, 10 rupees apni gaadi se pahunch jaoge.
Public transport is good. DTC is operating very well, but only in Delhi. But if you're talking about NCR, if you're talking about NCR, because I am putting at Noida, the DTC buses are pathetic.
Vehicles have to be made more expensive. At the same time, we have to create adequate public transport facilities.
But ask Delhiites if they would pay an extra 30% as environmental compensation to own cars, as has been suggested.
If they are charging in excess at the time of buying, and slowly they are, you know, giving you some kind of subsidy in diesel, I don't find anything wrong in it. They are doing good.
So you will not be in favor of an additional 30% on that?
I do not. Reason being, we are salaried employees.
Today, car is not a luxury, you know, it's a necessary for people. I think government should use its own funds for the pollution and all, and it should not charge from the people.
The biggest irony, perhaps, is that buses that account for 50% of transport are taxed higher than private cars, which means that instead of promoting public transport, our policies seem to discourage it. In New Delhi, Keetki Angre for NDTV.